Hello everybody out there on YouTube, this is Planeops123 and today we are going to be making some paper planes and yes, we will do a couple. They will go from the basic dart to the F-14 and yep, so let's start off with the dart. So this is a bit of a tutorial. Well, it is a tutorial. So you fold it in half. So it's like so. Fold it in half. Is that a better view? Yes. So then you open it up. Then you go and fold it into a triangle. But this is quite a big one. With this but. Okay, if you've ever made a dart before, and it's when you throw it across your garden or the road or whatever, it might spin around. That's because of a couple of factors. The wings and how the wings are designed. Okay, if I hold it, you can see the crease, and then you can see the fold. Let's see if I can focus it. There we go. See the fold, then the crease that folds it in half. You want to have it about 2 millimeters from the crease, and then that will help it not to spin around. And then exactly the same, but with the second fold. Like that. Sorry, I just did a little clump. Sorry. And then you can do a couple of things. This is basically personal preference. I like to get it the wings level. This bit I'll have to be doing it slightly off camera, so yeah, but I'll and now this is the finished product. You can, if you want to, make the wings here at the back like all flat and straight, but if you do, it can affect the airframe's performance. So if you stop it folding about here, it will give it those nice delta kind of winged shape. So yeah, that's the dart to make the bulldog. So if you've ever been flying paper planes for quite a long time, you would have noticed that when it comes in for kind of like a crash landing, the nose will get bent a little bit every time it does a landing. So it's starting to get a bit bent there. So what you can do to kind of like solve this problem is just fold the nose back, and doing this makes the aircraft slightly more maneuverable. And now with the nose like that, impossible, but well, virtually impossible to bend the nose. Hang on. So yeah, this is, I'm just gonna see if it, well, like any other like any other design for the nose, it will always get a little bit bent, but this is better than having it all. There we go, that proves my point. It's better to have it a little bit bent instead of it crushed. So, and it's good, that design. It's one of my favourite designs for planes because it's quite fast. Another one is, well, this one, it really always depends on how you fold it. and it goes like fold it in half. And then you have to fold it back a couple of times. Actually, so it goes to there. It really does depend on how you fold it, this design. So if you get it wrong, it will not fly at all. It will just be like a flop when it tries to fly, it'll just spin out of control, which isn't what you want. You want it to, because this aircraft is designed to go for long distance. Well, not long distance. It's got a long time in the air, and that's what it's designed for. So you can, instead of like a normal bulldog or dart, whatever, flying for about 2 seconds, this will be able to hopefully fly for about 11 seconds. I don't know, I'm just gonna test fly it in here whilst I'm recording. And if this works, I'll make a second video of it flying outside. It does fly, it's just not the best at flying, but it does fly. So, yes, we are going to be making the Harrier. That's right, we're going to actually be making a paper Harrier. So, to do this, you need to start it off identical to the bulldog slash dart, and then go like this. Exactly the same. You can do the millimeter thing. My sleeve is just falling down because I've got my thermals on, because I can't be bothered to wear a t-shirt, but I've got it folded up so you can see. So it won't be like here, and there won't be like something getting in the way so you can't see. So it's just easier like that. So yeah. And then fold it back on itself, like so. So it looks a bit like an envelope. And then, because if it's an envelope, there's always something that has to pop out. And oh, here it is. It's a Harrier! Yes, so. And then, that stupid sleeve. Okay, so it's like an envelope. Then you fold it back to here. And then it starts to take shape like that. I just focus it. There we go. So it looks like that, and then fold it up, a little tab up. Now for this bit you will need a corner. So for this I'm going to use the Apple iPhone 3GS box for this demonstration. Then you fold it back, and then the wing, and then the nose of the aircraft may look a bit square, so you can just put your thumb or finger or whatever, like a pencil or anything, up there, and it will straighten it out. And then try and get the wings as neat as possible. Ooh, my helmet. Sorry, I've been listening to Surfing Bird, so I might be going ooh my mama, ooh my mama. So yes, there we go. If you want it to go faster, you put the wings up at this angle here. You put it up a bit more, and then it becomes faster to make it glide more, so it spends more time in the air. You put it down some more, and then it's basically like that for anything that you want, like preferences wise. And then, yep, so that's the Harrier. I know it doesn't look too much like the Harrier, but this is a very good tip for flying. Okay, people of the internet, listen closely. Does your plane fly upside down most of the time? Because if it does, this is probably what it looks like. The wings pointing down, just like a fighter jet. Now, if it does point down like a fighter jet, you want to pull them up a little bit. Okay, this is dihedral, and this is anhedral. So, you want it to be dihedral. So, if there's a gust of wind and it blows it to one side, it will level it out. If you want it to go faster, you want the wings to be as level as possible. And then, but if you want it to glide quite far, you put the wings up just the tiniest amount, literally. So it's a bit, it's not, they're not dead level, and they're not all the way up like if you want it to glide, and if you want it to be a safe flyer, if you want to call it that. So yeah, and there are two like spikes at the back you can roll up. So just go like pull them up, then you can just brush them backwards and they'll go down a bit, and then there's your elevator. And they're a lot easier to make because you don't need scissors or like a Swiss Army knife or anything. So now to this aircraft here. If you are American, you would have probably already recognised this aircraft. Yes, it is retired now, sadly. It was used in probably one of the most famous action films ever made. Tom Cruise absolutely adores them. They have probably the most famous, they are probably the most famous swing wing aircraft ever, and that is the F-14. So let's put that down and let's crack on with making it, because this video is about 10 minutes long. So it's going to be about 40 minutes long, so probably this might be my longest ever video. So if I can remember rightly, you fold it this way. Yes, I think I'm doing this correct. Yes, and then you open it up. I'm just trying to remember. Ah, no. You keep it like that. Fold it in half. So it's like this. Then open it up, point it to about the middle. Then open it up, put it all in. Okay, this is the most fiddliest part of the whole folding stage. So then it works out like this. Then you fold it. Then you fold it back so it's like this. See, I've got it stuck in my head. Surfing bird. Surfing bird. Then you fold it on its back. goes like this, and like this, I'm lost. And then fold these bits up. Fold these bits up. The wings will be in the permanent swept back position, but if you've got a little bit of tape, which I don't, so I'm not prepared for this video, really, you put them, you stick it down there, and then it literally flies like a dream. And because, as I've said with the bulldog here, flat nose, no bending. And yeah, so that's from a simple design to a more complicated in the span of about 15 minutes. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon when we fly these three to the max.